Wala nang mas aakit pa kaysa sa isang motor na classic at vintage. Andoon na ang heritage at samot-saring mga kwento na nakapalibot sa isang lumang motor dahil dala nito ang mga alaala at importanteng kaganapan ng mga panahon na yon. And just like wine, these bikes get better with age. Yun lang, di lahat ng tao kaya panindigan or i-maintain ang mga topak ng lumang motor dahil ang sarap at ibig sa luma ng iba ay sakit sa ulo ng ilang nakararami. Kaya ayun, maraming manufacturers ang siyang nakaisip na gumawa ng modern classic. Isang motor na mukhang luma pero bibit-bit ang mga bagahe ng sinauna. Isang motor na mukhang classic pero armado ng mga modernong ginhawa ng bagong motor. Isa na dito ay yung Bristol 250 featuring the BR250 and yung Classic 250. Diretsuhin ko na kayo. Presyo niya ngayon ay nasa 128,000 pesos. And obviously, nakasuot siya para lumaban sa mga 150cc and below automatics na andun din ang presyohan. Bristol 250. So eto na ang maliit na kapatid ng very successful and very good performing Bristol 400 na lumabas noong 2018. Medyo mataas ang expectation ko dahil sa unang nakita ko sa Bristol 400. Specs: single cylinder, 4-stroke, air-cooled, single overhead cam, passing Euro 3 emission standards. It is 5-speed, it is carbureted with electric start. Power is at 13 kilowatts at 7,500 RPM with torque at 18 Nm. Fuel tank can take in a generous 14 liters. It's got single disc brakes front and back with inverted forks out front.
So I just walked out of my house. I heard a guy with a British accent.
Australian, man.
Hey. Australian. I'm sorry. It's still close.
No worries.
He's wearing a Bristol shirt, and he's got a 400, and I'm introducing the 250. What do you think?
Well, I had a Harley, a wide glide, 1450, 99,
uh-huh.
Dyno wide glide, big heavy bike. I want to go down a small thing, but I still want to keep on the freeways and on the skyways.
So that's why you got the 400.
Exactly.
Okay.
So I could cope with that. What I reckon about the 250 here, it's a beautiful bike, the single, one pipe. What I'd like to see Bristol bring out is some exhaust pipes.
Like actual Bristol branded exhaust pipes.
Yeah. What we lack here in the Philippines is the accessories for these bikes. The 250 comes with this fairing, but if you go to the 400, you can't get a fairing.
So you want to get the accessories for the 400. I think that's a good idea. You know what? I'm going to be talking to the guys who brought it in. This is Bristol. This is a Bristol branded.
Yeah, but you can't get it for my bike.
Okay. Well, they should make one for your bike then.
Well, of course they should.
Okay, and, I'll see you around. Just drop by. Want to grab a beer one day? My name is Zach.
Zach Kev, man.
Kev.
Yeah, Kev.
Cheers.
Yeah, take care.
Bye. Let's try the brakes. Let's talk about the rear first, okay? Some brakes for the rear. A bit of fifth-tailing action. So if you're into that, that will work beautifully. That can be fun off-road, doing side brakes and all. Let's try the front now. Okay, good front brake, very good. Oh. Okay. Alright. So you know what? Bottom line, two brakes, that's the way to do it. Front brakes is really, really nice. I like it for this one. I didn't feel like I was gonna lose the front. And be careful with the rear.
Overall, kung build and fit and finish ang pag-uusapan natin dito versus its older sibling, iba talagang quality ng Bristol 400. Pero iba din presyo nun. At sa tingin ko, kaya nila na ibaba yung presyo ng ganyan is because of aesthetics. But this engine for a 250cc is fine for me. I didn't feel na yung pagkamura niya ay dahil sa makina. Now about the aesthetics, some good points about it. If you're in the custom mood or you like modding your bike, dahil mura siya, marami kang leeway para puliduhin to at i-custom to your taste. Pero may iba din naman na ayaw na kumuteng-teng. Like the Bristol 400cc, off the shelf, sold na yun eh. Handling and stability. Magpapalit ako ng gulong. At that width, at kung gusto mo maglaro sa kanto, bibili ako ng mas makapit and slightly thicker tires, especially for the racer. Suspension in the seat between the two, the Classic will be far more comfortable. I like the looks of the racer, but if you're gonna go for longer rides, doon na ako sa Classic. Power and engine-wise, this 250cc dial carb siya actually has a lot of pizzazz with the lower gears. Huligan yung dating. Makakatuwa. This is my gripe with some FI small displacements. They feel so behaved. The Bristol 250 has that loco factor sa alis niya. May diin sa lihing, ika nga. We got these two beauties over here. Look-wise, I am gonna go for the cafe look by far. Although this is quite the elegant standard looking bike, like a small little Triumph, that kind of works, but I'm gonna go for this one. The finish over this overall quality, if I were to compare this versus the Bristol 400, if you have the cash, go for the Bristol 400. There's absolutely no argument. But I'm not saying this is a slouch. Hindi rin. I mean, aban din eh. Pero between them, 400 of course. Now, these are aluminum, so there's value right there. Same with that aluminum, it's pretty much identical. Everything else is identical, with the exception of the cowl and the headlight, the mirror, and of course the seat. Carbureted, brakes, got shocks. Yeah, notable things about this one, naka-inverted forks na siya. Same with this one. So that part, okay yun. Scrutinizing the welds, I would say it's also a not bad job. This is plastic. Would have been nice if this was metal. Same with this one. Other thing that I would change here would be the vinyl seat. This is like vinyl, shiny, plasticky all the way. So it's got some, I don't know, I think pseudo stitching here. I can't tell, but unless I look under, I see some thread, but I'm not sure if that's for look or if it serves an actual purpose. To make this even cooler, I'd change that. The little details like the side view mirrors, this is much, much better than this one. This is kind of quirky looking for me. If you're gonna go for the standard one, I would change this. This kind of looks off. If you look at it, it just like sticks out up there like antennas. This one is sleek. It can go down here. There is an adjustment. If you take this little thing out, there's a little screw that you can loosen. So if you want to raise this up a bit, if you want a sleeker look, that's no problem. Another obvious difference is the pipe. Let you listen. Give it a start here. This won't start with a side stand on. Basically, this is our pipe. Smooth sounding, if I may describe that. Let's go to the standard bike this time. That now. Between the two pipes, I don't know. I think I kind of like this one. It's got a little thumpa 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 sound to it that I think bagay dito sa look na to. Well, this has a nice smooth linear sound. I don't know what to toss up between the two, but may characteristic to na natutuwa ako, so I think I'm gonna go for that pipe. Just if I had to choose. The gauges are identical. Looks classic when it's shut down, but when you turn it on, it looks quite modern. I would say this is a not bad job at all. It's not over the top, but it's not bad either. That's pretty much it. I've been fiddling around the sides. I can't find any other buttons here. But when you turn it on and off, it's that strip odometer, and then there's also miles and kilometers, so there's a provision here for that, and I'm just not quite sure where you're supposed to press that, because I see no other thing that you can press here. It's not there. Yeah, so it must be an internal set or something. Some notes here, I guess it depends on how you're riding, but if your boot is here and it's touching the pipe, sorry, that's my chinelas, and you can see how that can melt your shoe when it gets hot, and I think it has happened. I'm not sure which of my shoes got in there. But you can see how that can touch the pipe, right? See, so maybe that's an improvement in design that they can sort out. But if you're conscious of it, then you can just avoid it, keep the distance. But sometimes, depends on how you ride, you touch that, sunog yung sapatos mo. So be wary of that and see the position. This heat shield would have been cool there, actually. It would be protecting your shoe more. Switches wise, again, you can't expect much at this price point. The switches are so-so. The detail here is okay. Again, it's not like the Bristol 400. The Bristol 400 is head and shoulders above this one. Also, for the cafe, I would get clip-ons. This is a bit high for me for a racer. I would want clip-ons that are here and also here. This is baba. And then I would get a rear set to put this even more at the back. Papalit ako ng grips. That's what I would do. Classic looking bike, you can't really judge its stability and sturdiness because it's from a classic era. They really tried to go back in time with this. If I were to be reminded of the Bristol 400, yun grabe yun, that price point and what it was trying to give out at that level was pretty good. I kind of understand why this would be in that price range. There are certain parts here that to save more money, they would save on, like, you know, the switches, like what I mentioned. The seat upholstery also, they'd be saving money on that. So far, the engine, with my time with it, wala naman akong nakitang problem or knocking sound. And actually, I was pushing this bike hard. I was really riding this tough. I'd say in the 250cc segment, it was behaving like a proper 250 na carb. So, saan po may pwesto ang Bristol 250? Sa halagang 128,000 pesos, medyo mapapaisip ka rin eh. Mas mura siya kaysa sa mga ibang premium automatics, mas malakas, de cambio, at classic looking. Pansantabi muna natin ang looks and style, at engine power na lang ang pag-usapan natin. Naka 250cc ka na dito, napakalakas ng argumento kung iisipin mo. Pero yun nga, kahit 250cc siya, pare-pareho pa rin silang hindi maka-highway. So saan magagamit yung extra na lakas, diba? Pwede mong katwiran yun. Marami din naman sa mga backroads, sa mga twisties, down south, etc. Kung sa budgetan lang pinag-uusapan, kung kakayanin pa ng konting tiis at ipon, doon ako sa Bristol 400. Iba yung fit and finish noon. Pogi din. At makaka-highway. Pero within this bracket with what you were getting for your pesos and cents, at kung di mo na type at graduate ka na sa mga scooter, the Bristol 250 comes strong with its value proposition again at 128,000 pesos. The classic resurgence has been in trend for over a decade, and by how everyone is behaving thus far, it looks like it's gonna be around indefinitely. This is Zach from Makina Motor Features. Ciao!
Kahit na ang bahaghari, sikretong babahagi, mga ulap bihahawi. Nais ko rin mawari sa puso mo mamalagi. Makita ka palagi, lungkot ko ay napapawi. Matamis na iyong labi, sa isip ko sumasagi. Hiraya manawari, sana ay ganito palagi. Tila yata ay nayari, sa swerte ako'y palugi. Di na nga magpapalugi, pwede ba kitang maari na? Talunin.
Sakaling ang mundo bukas ay kumuho, basta ang alam mo, ikaw ang mahal ko.
Pakinggan mo sana mga nakatagong mga himig, handog na may pag-ibig, dalang mga ligalig. Buwan akong kinikilig, masdan mo umiibig. Sa dagat mo sigasig, mapayapa kitang iniibig. Malapili ko lang marami ang nakaabang, mga matang nakapaligid, ayaw pa lamang. Malamang, di ako magtatabang, di ka sana magsawa, hindi ako malalamang.
Oh,
pagkataas ay tatalunin. Sapat ng pahiwatig, wala na ang iyong galit.
Gabi-gabi na lang ikaw ang aking panaginip.
Ngiti hanggang gilagit, sa'yo ay naaakit.
Sabay halik sa hangin, malakas na pagkaihip.
Mga tanong na bakit ako'y nilalait.
Maramdaman mo sana at sumagi sa iyong isip.
Gusto ko mang lumapit, maraming nakasingit.
Puso mo'y nasilip, nabigong paulit-ulit. Bilog ang mundo, huwag mo sanang iikot sa atin. Malay ba natin kung para ba talaga sa atin?
Ikaw'y alanganin, hinga ka lang malalim. Palasyo na mahangin, partida pikit ka lang at
talon.
Kahit gaano kataas ay tatalunin. Thank you.